Good morning, everybody, and welcome once again to the Parish of All Saints, Harrow Weald. I'm Father John Barker, the parish vicar. We're a Church of England parish, part of the Diocese of London. And for the moment, our worship is live streamed. We're waiting, we're praying, and we're taking care, waiting for it to be possible for us to return to All Saints for our worship. In the meantime, we're worshipping online. Today it's going to be a service from Common Worship, prayer during the day. And each week we have this service, and within the service we include by name people who have long-term health issues, and we pray for God to be with them and give them strength as they live with various afflictions. Our service will begin at around 11:30 UK time. And our theme is today is very much linked to the teachings of Jesus in Matthew's Gospel. And our first introduction to worship music is from the musical Godspell, which told the story of Matthew's Gospel in a contemporary way for the people of the 1970s and 80s, day by day. Hello again. If you just joined us, maybe you're wondering why it was music from Godspell. Well, I explained when we first started that today we're going to be focusing in our prayer during the day on the teachings of Jesus in Matthew's Gospel. And Godspell was, of course, a 1970s musical which presented, in the views of the writers, their interpretation of Matthew's Gospel, and that was Day by Day, Three Things We Pray. See thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, follow thee more nearly. And that will be our theme this morning. Let's say prayer during the day. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. With you, O God, is the well of life. In your light shall we see light. And now I invite you to join in prayer. We can do it responsorially. Let us pray. Jesus, Saviour of the world, come to us in your mercy. We look to you to save and help us. By your cross and your life laid down, you set your people free. We look to you to save and help us. When they were ready to perish, you saved your disciples. We look to you to come to our help. In the greatness of your mercy, loose us from our chains. Forgive the sins of your people. Make yourself known as our Saviour and mighty Deliverer. Save us and help us that we may praise you. Come now and dwell with us, Lord Christ Jesus. Hear our prayer and be with us always. And when you come in your glory, make us to be one with you and to share the life of your kingdom. Amen. Our day psalm, Psalm 23. With the refrain, I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. He shall refresh my soul and guide me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You've anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely goodness and loving mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. O God, our sovereign and shepherd, who brought again your Son Jesus Christ from the valley of death, comfort us with your protecting presence and your angels and of goodness and love, that we also may come home and dwell with him in your house forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Surely goodness and loving mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, day by day. Three things I pray. Our verses from the Bible, from the second book of Chronicles, two verses from the seventh chapter. When I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or command the locusts to devour the land, or send pestilence among my people, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Jesus said, I'm the good shepherd. There's one thing that I remember about being a shepherd from the days back working on the farm. There was never such a thing as a day off with sheep. Yes, you could take a day off, of course you could, but the responsibility for the sheep and for the cows and for the pigs and the hens that we had on the farm, that was unceasing. And if you wonder why farmers, as a rule, take very little by way of holidays, I know why. It was so difficult to arrange cover to make sure everything was done while you were away. It was often easier just to stay at home and not take a break. And if you did take a break, there was always a problem when you come back. So a shepherd, a good shepherd, can never rest. A good shepherd is caring and loving all of the time. Now, Jesus said he's a good shepherd. That means, by implication, we are his sheep. So what can we do in our turn? Well, in the Book of Chronicles, the writer is saying that the sheep are sometimes pretty horrible creatures. They sometimes pollute the environment. They sometimes waste food. They sometimes abuse defenseless people. They're sometimes cruel to dumb animals. They sometimes are irresponsible and don't take care when they have a virus, travel across countries and go close together. I'm just using examples. Can any of us say that we have never at least thought about at least one of those? So we are the sheep, and we're not perfect. But the writer of Chronicles says that even if we, as imperfect as we are, understand how stupid we are and humble ourselves, pray to God, look for God, and do our best to stop being so stupid and wicked, then God will forgive our sins and heal our land. Gosh, there is maybe even hope for life after COVID. And if there is, and when there is, let us give thanks to God for that. Of course the scientists have been great. Of course the doctors have been wonderful, and the nurses and the carers and all of the other frontline workers. Everybody has played their part, but we are sheep. It's a good shepherd that has seen, forgives us, and heals us. All we can do is, day by day, pray three things: that we can see God more clearly, that we can love him more dearly, and follow him more nearly. Yes, day by day. Amen. And now let's say our day prayers. Dear loving Heavenly Father, as we worship you this morning, we pray that we, as your sheep, may understand that we have done so many things which are selfish and silly, sometimes cruel, very often thoughtless. May we turn from those sins and commend ourselves to your mercy and commit ourselves to doing your will and shining your light. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we admit that these days are not easy. Living in a pandemic creates all sorts of anxieties and stresses and tensions. Give us strength, Lord. Give us peace in our souls, that we can live, that we can share, that we can love, and that we can shine your light. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we pray for those who we know and love. We give thanks that we have family, that we have friends. We pray that soon we may be able to meet again. And now we remember those who have particular needs at this time. We hold them in our hearts and we pray that you will be with them and that they may feel your comfort and your support, that they may gain strength from your love and the peace which only you can give in their souls. By name, we continue to pray for Natasha Jackson Boo, for Asha Solianki, for Catherine Jones, for Siobhan Renson, for Nora McHugh-Nee and other members of her family all suffering from coronavirus. For Matthew Giuliani, Noel Bevan, Roger Siswick, Jane Slade, Janice Glasser, Margaret Vintner, Doris Reed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, you taught us to love our neighbour and to care for those in need as if we were caring for you. In this time of anxiety, give us strength to comfort the fearful, to tend the sick, and to assure the isolated of our love and your love for your name's sake. And by name, we commend to you today those who are on our long-term parish prayer list. We pray for Emma Foss, for Linda Fidler, Sheila Ward, Claire Roding, Laura Baker, George Baldwin, Valerie Booth, Massimo and Amber Baresta, Irene Buttress, Betty Brown, David Carpenter, Peter Halsey, Dory and Cyril Crook, Jovita Dias, Wendy and John Frith, Alison Harvey, Mary Holmes, Mike Kennedy, Marshall White, Herbert Lubin, Timothy Moore, Elizabeth Ruffle, Callum Shakespeare, Bob Todd, Liz and John Wilkinson, Tracy James, Stephen Thompson, Michael and Jean Sorbs, and David Leslie. May they all feel your love and your peace surrounding them. Amen. And now we commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. And our collect for this day. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for all the benefits you have won for us, for all the pains and insults you have borne for us. Most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. May Christ our Saviour give us peace. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and with all those who you love, wherever they may be, today and always. Amen. Thank you so much for joining our worship again this morning, wherever you are. I hope that your day is starting well and will become even better. Our day collect was the prayer of St. Richard of Chichester, and it's another interpretation of the teaching of Jesus in the Gospel of Matthew. So it's a more traditional interpretation of God's spell and day by day. And so as our closing music, we're going to hear a beautiful choral interpretation of the prayer of St. Richard. Pretty certain it's from Lichfield Cathedral. Wherever he's from, the young man has a beautiful voice. And so I'll leave you with the prayer of St. Richard for this morning, inviting you to join again, if you wish, tomorrow. Our worship tomorrow will be that traditional favourite, Comple, night prayer, from the Book of Common Prayer. That will be at 6 p.m. tomorrow, which, just to remind you, will be Saturday. Until then, keep well, keep safe, and may we, day by day, seek to love God more dearly, follow him more nearly, and see him more clearly. Goodbye.